We can communicate with the astronauts. Now let's give a warm welcome and applaud to the astronauts.
Is established between ground and space. Our astronauts in the middle is the lecturer of today's lesson, Wang Yaping, and she is China's second female astronaut.
Good morning, dear students. I am Wang Yaping, and I will give the lecture today. Good morning. I am Nie Haisheng, and I'm the commander of the mission. Good morning. I'm Zhang Xiaoguang, and I will be the photographer of this lecture. Now we are 300 kilometers above the surface, and I'm in the Tiangong module, and I will say hello to you. You know that witnessness is unique to the aerospace. So let's invite our commander to perform some difficult motions for you. No problem.
So
I can sit cross-legged in the air.
The commander of the Shenzhou 10 mission, Nie Haisheng, is going to do some little tricks in space in this weightless environment. He looks pretty much like a floating monk, bumping against the wall. So back in ground, during their training, engineers have simulated the space environment many, many times.
And in a weightless environment, we are very skillful martial artists. So in a weightless environment, does it mean that our body mass will turn zero? If we can measure that, that would be good. So I have a question for the students. How can we measure the mass of an object in our daily life?
So we're seeing a bit of interaction from the Tiangong 1 module in space and our classroom on the ground.
Now we can use the scale to measure the mass, and in the science lab, I can use a tray scale.
还有谁想？好，你把话筒递给旁边那位同学吧。在家时，我用电子秤量自己的体重。如果要测大物体的质量，这种办法来测量物体的质量。好，接下来。
好，第三排这位女生。我们还可以利用动量守恒，利用碰撞，
And we can also use the conservation of momentum, and to let the two objects collide with each other, to measure the mass.
These students have so many questions for the astronauts. Their curiosity about space is huge.
亚平老师您好，我想到了三种方法测量物体的质量。
I think about three methods.
首先呢，就是说在中药房中可以用等子，也就是杆秤来测量药品的质量。那我们去买菜买水的时候，我们也可以使用这个托盘秤来测量蔬菜质量。
第三种呢，就是当我们进入物理实验室，进行物理实验的时候，我们可以使用弹簧测力器监测出物体所受的重力，在空中来计算出物体的质量。好，亚平老师。同学们回答的都非常好。You came up with very good ideas.
那么这些在地面上测质量的方法，do
the methods that work on the Earth are still can still at work in the space?
同学们看,
you see, these are two exactly the same springs. At the other end of the spring are other objects with different masses. If we are now in the, on the Earth, then the stretch would be different. But now, the springs are in the same position. They cannot indicate the difference in the mass. So in space, if an astronaut wants to know whether he's getting fatter or thinner, what can he do? You don't have to worry. We have an instrument to measure the mass, the weight measurement instrument. And this is an instrument. And it is a strand. You can put the astronaut here. And then the commander and I will perform the experiment. You can guess the weight of our commander. Now the experiment begins. We let the commander stand on the instrument. And then we pull the steel rope to a certain place. And the pulling force makes him fall back to the initial position, and then we can know the weight. Now we see the weight. It's 74 kilos. Do you have the right guess?
So that was the first set of experiments done by our teacher in space.
And what is the physical principle behind this instrument? It is the Newton's second law of motion. The force imposed on an object equals to the multiplication of its mass and acceleration. If we can measure the force and the acceleration, we can know the mass. So we have a spring cam structure. It can exert a constant force. Namely the force that pulling the commander into the initial position. And we also have a grating speed measurement system to measure the acceleration. And according to the law, we can measure the weight. Isn't it amazing? And now I have another question for you. In space, except for such a contraption to measure weight, are there any other methods? Now you can see my operation, and I can give you some hint. And this is a spring I just showed you. I pull the two springs into the same position, and then let it go. So the vibration frequency is different for two objects. This is the same as if we do this experiment on the Earth.
So,
according to this phenomenon, can we come up with some other method to measure the mass? And you can think about that. Now let's do another experiment.
This
is a strand, and the rope can tie this little ball to the strand, which is a single pendulum, as we commonly see on the Earth.
Yeah.
So now the question is, if you set up a pendulum aboard an orbiting space vehicle, would the period be less than, the same as, or greater than it would be in our lab on the ground?
它并没有像在地面一样做往复摆动.
It does not swing as it did on the Earth. So let's move it higher to here.
它还是没有做往复摆动.
It doesn't swing either.
这是为什么呢?
Why?
因为在太空中,
because in space, it is a weightless environment. There is no force, so it cannot swing as it does on the Earth. And if we push the little ball, what will happen? You see, it's amazing. It's now orbiting. It moves in circular motion.
Now, this is indeed quite amazing. Let's turn our attention to, let's turn to our studio guest, Mr. Wei. How would you explain this phenomenon?
I think demonstration
all demonstrate the important concept, its mass and the force. So what we measure, the mass of material is constant, but the force is not. It depends on the acceleration. So on ground, we have a constant acceleration, about 9.8 meter per square of seconds. So that's why we take this default number and merge the mass. It's because we know this one is constant, but in space, we don't have this constant anymore. We need to calculate this one. That's why we use acceleration to generate this.
So this is based on the Newton's second law of motion,
exactly, on ground,
explaining the relationship between force and acceleration.